It's all a matter of perception. Where we stand in space and time. There is no you or me that I can see.
Welcome back to Soul Perspectives.
I'm Kip.
And I'm Evan.
Today we're going to ask this question, why can't we get healthy?
Why can't we get healthy?
Why can't we get healthy?
You would think that'd be the simplest thing, the most obvious thing, the most natural thing for us, that we would put our brain power towards the thriving of this one body, this one life that we get. And clearly, every being, every animal on Earth has the biological imperative to survive. What's the meaning of life? To live it, to live it to the fullest, to get through it as far as we can. And it seems that our lifestyles and our culture run so counter to that, that it's keeping us from getting healthy.
Well, and you know, we've talked about this many times. It's amazing to me that we consider ourselves the most intelligent creatures literally in the known universe, according to us, yet we don't even know what foods to eat that make us healthy when every other animal can walk out in the woods, grab whatever they eat, somehow manage to get through the day just fine, but not us. And when we do find foods that we want to eat, so much of it's poison.
Yeah.
So much of our current diet is flat out poison.
Yeah, why can't we get healthy? Just start with the simple question. What beverage does every animal on the face of the planet drink exclusively?
Coca-Cola.
Wrong. No, that's the one we drink.
Oh, that's right. I get it confused.
But then you look at what we drink in our beverages, and they all... I'm someone who tries to be careful about the sugar intake, and I make a very conscious effort. In fact, when it comes to beverages, there are almost none commercially available that you can drink. I mean, maybe black coffee or tea without any sweetener, water. That's about it. Those are about the only ones I know of. Maybe a sparkling water with the hint of lemon kind of thing. But as far as a beverage that is sold that is not very highly concentrated sugar, juices, sodas, dairy products, everything on the shelves, energy drinks, the sports drinks, the vitamin water, that's my favorite healthy, quote, read, not healthy, beverage, is the vitamin water. You're going to get your vitamins. It just sounds healthy. And two of the most poisonous words in our culture are sugar-free. So don't fall into that trap. Be sure and recognize what we're putting in. So why can't we get healthy? I think the bottom line is because we're not paying attention. And because we haven't done the research to know what healthy choices would look like.
Well, and to stick with the sugar kick, you're right. If you get black coffee, it doesn't have any sugar in it. But walk into any grocery store, look at their pre-bottled coffees. Oh. Try to find one without sugar.
Yeah.
It's a real challenge. Go into Starbucks. Next time you order your mocha, ask them how many pumps of syrup and stuff they put in it. Literally, I'll go in, I will ask for a half pump, and it's still too sweet. They put in 5 full pumps. Every day I'll get white tea with guava juice, just a splash of guava juice. The way that's supposed to be, it's supposed to be half guava juice, syrup, and lemonade with this tea. I'm like, how is anyone eating this without literally just walking away with diabetes and all your teeth rotting out?
Yeah, well, we kind of are. It's just, it's a slow march to self-destruction that way. But the bottom line is that it's pretty simple and obvious what there is to be eating. It's the natural things that the earth provides us. Again, just like every other animal, those animals don't have to decide what to cook for dinner and determine what they can afford at the market. And they go with what grows out of the ground and what fits, what works for them. And we overcomplicate. And the fact of the matter is we're literally being sold a bill of goods. We're victims of industry, of the fact that each of us has to do something to feed our family, to provide for our family. And that's at the bottom line of all business. It's people trying to feed their family. Yeah. That's why we go to work. That's why we start companies. And ultimately why business thrives. Money makes the world go round, but it provides our needs for us. The problem is that in industry, we get so far removed from the actual nurturing, the actual component of the food that we're utilizing for our survival and our health, has been completely divorced from the money-making, marketing aspect of it. And when the pursuit of profit is the motivation, that's very dangerous.
Well, if you ask most people, which animals know instinctively, why do you eat? Why are you eating? What is food? Food is fuel. That's all it is. Mm-hmm. We've turned it in, it's been programmed into us that it's entertainment.
Yes.
So we get all hooked in the entertainment aspect of it. So we consume more and more of it. Yeah. And of course, ingredients, and then we get addicted to that make us want to consume more and more. Mm-hmm. And we get increasingly more healthy. All food is fuel, so you can actually experience life.
Yeah.
That's what food really is. There's some really great shows on National Geographic all about primal survival. And it's not like going out in Survivor Man, you plane wreck, whatever, get trapped in the Andes. It's about going and living with tribal people and seeing how they live, how they go out and get their food. And what I've gotten from all of these shows is, one, tribal people understand it's all fuel. They aren't gluttons. They'll, sure, maybe you get together and you have your big feast, come back and celebrate the harvest or the hunt or whatever. But that's the rarity. It's not every day. You don't have everything you want all the time. And what I've gotten from all of this is the appreciation that you have for your food. Mm-hmm. It changes entirely. Like, there was one episode I watched on National Geographic. This guy is with these Chinese tribesmen. They go to the base of the Himalayas because they've got to get this sacred honey from these giant Himalayan honeybees. Got to climb up literally a sheer cliff, then smoke them out so he can put all the honey in the tube. He gets down, he's got bees in his hair, on his face, stuck to his face from the honey. He's tasting the honey, he's like, this tastes like peaches. It's the best honey I've ever had. And I'm like, God, that's so beautiful. That connection to just appreciation for your food and to know you're getting something that's so good for your body at the same time.
Well, I think the bottom line, you know, answer to the question, why can't we get healthy? Because we are not using food to nourish ourselves.
Exactly.
Because food has become entertainment. It's become, there's, the ritual has been so skewed. It's one thing to have a ritual around eating, honor the body, honor the food, show gratitude, create sacred space, calm down the pressures of the day and the distractions, unify with our tribe and celebrate the bounty of the harvest and the meal that's before us. But the rituals that we've created around food are party time, cake and ice cream at a birthday,
24/7 vomitorium.
We're getting together, we're gonna go out and have a fancy meal at a fancy restaurant, read poison, you know, pizza, the all-American party food. These foods are not our friends. We can't get healthy because we can't get our heads around the fact that what we do for fun and amusement and entertainment and what we do for to create unity and build bonds in our tribe are not what the food is about, are not what, like we've said, food is there to nourish us, to give us energy. The other big question that goes along with that is, how much energy do we need? Are we weighing? We're not paying attention because we'd be weighing what am I doing today? How much energy will that require? Therefore, what am I going to eat? I'm going to eat differently if I'm hiking up that mountain over there than a day I'm going to have a lazy Sunday and read the Sunday paper, which I wouldn't do, but you go ahead. The fact is, those are two very different energy levels and exertion amounts, and they require different amounts of fuel to power them.
Right.
So it's consciousness. It's putting thought into it. It's doing the research. It's putting thought into what am I putting in my body. And then beyond all of this, there's this whole concept of the pleasure trap. And really, we have gotten into quite a rut. I will speak personally for sure on this. When I am caught in the pleasure trap and addicted to the addictive ingredients that are in the food, whether it be just simply sugar itself or sugar derivatives, or the more powerful chemicals and toxins that are in the food to keep us addicted and keep us eating. There's a reason why they have those commercials, you bet you can't eat just one. Well, their bet is hedged because they've put things in there that make us want it. I mean, we're going beyond just the three essentials. Any restaurant or business that is making their viability from providing us food, in order for them to stay viable, there are three things that they must use, three tools that they must use in that food in order to keep people eating and keep people buying. And those are salt, fat, and of course, sugar. That is how you sell food. That is how you sell food. We've watched countless healthy restaurants that are doing the right thing and just providing nourishment for people go under because you can't, you're not getting the people addicted. They don't love your food and we crave it and we gotta have more and I'm gonna bring all my friends here because it's so amazing. No one ever says, you gotta go eat there. It's so healthy. You're gonna feel so good when you leave. It just doesn't work. People, our culture doesn't support that. Well, so we need to put the bad stuff in to sell it.
And here's something we all need to think about. Not only is the food we're eating unhealthy for us, the food that we're eating is unhealthy for the planet. The food that we're eating is unhealthy for the planet. That beef you're eating, that palm oil, it's unhealthy for the planet. The Roundup that we're spraying on, spraying on everything is poison. It's unhealthy for the planet.
It's unhealthy for the gut biome. Here's a big thing that a lot of people aren't aware of is the pesticides that go on the foods in the fields, whether they're feeding the animals you eat or you're eating the food, the produce directly, it kills pests. What is it doing in the body? It's killing something. It's either harming our own tissue or it's killing off the precious gut biome, the bacteria, the good bacteria that are in us that help us digest, that help keep us healthy, that help fight off the bad bacteria and the viruses and keep the immune system active and healthy and adequately functioning. So why can't we get healthy? Because we can't get ourselves in balance and in a healthy, thriving state to be able to ward off the viruses and diseases that we get. And the chronic metabolic conditions like diabetes, heart disease, cancers, they're coming straight from the foods. They're coming straight from the foods. Why can't we get healthy? Because we're not paying attention, because we're not doing the research, because we're not supporting one another in doing the healthy thing. We're allowing ourselves and encouraging each other to keep doing the things that we pretty much know are harmful, whether we're in denial of it or admitting it. I know, how often do we say, I know I shouldn't, but, dot, dot, dot. Why can't we get healthy? Because of the buts.
Well, and I think it's really important to not just let it pass and people go, oh, a few bacteria in my stomach, whatever, if they're around there. No, listen to me on this.
Yeah.
Only when you look in the mirror, and you look at reflection, only 10% of that reflection is human DNA. The rest of it is all of this flora and fauna that make us up. So when you're saying, oh, it's only a few bacteria, it's only a couple of the flora and fauna that are occupying and doing this work and actually part of my intelligence that exists in my gut. No, you're actually killing most of what you actually are.
Yeah, it really is suicidal. It may be a long, slow death, but it's suicidal to be putting the poisons in our body and putting known poisons in our body. And then there's a whole other aspect to this. Why can't we get healthy? Is on the treatment side. The medical system, the doctors who don't have any training in nutrition, the fact that nobody is acknowledging that the issue is what we're putting in the body and that we could rectify probably 90% of our health problems with proper eating and maybe some exercise thrown in for good measure.
Yep.
But we're not getting supported by the medical industry, by the doctors. They don't know better. They're paid to push drugs. They're taught in medical school what works, what fixes things, and the bottom line is they're only there to make you comfortable in the face of symptoms. They're not even treating symptoms, they're treating your reaction to the symptoms, which are really caused by the problems that we're not even talking about, let alone facing, addressing, and working to heal.
And to a point you made earlier that I want to speak to again is you don't have to eat as much as you are. You think you do. You're not hungry when you think you're hungry.
Yeah.
Try to go a couple days eating less. Try to go a whole day without eating at all. You're not going to die.
No, you will not die not eating. No one has ever died not eating in a day. I don't have the research on that one, but I feel pretty confident that no one has ever died from not eating for one day.
In fact, I've heard that if you are to fast for 3 days, it completely resets your immune system.
Mm.
So quite to the contrary, because when we're in the wild, we're not going, oh, there's McDonald's, there's 7-Eleven, there's Safeway, there's Whole Foods.
Yeah.
No, we're going, okay, where's my next meal? There's my next meal. Eat as much as I want, let it digest. Maybe I won't have another meal for a day. Who
Tomorrow
knows?
Might be a drought.
Yeah.
Tomorrow the animals might have taken all the berries off the bush. Right. I'm quite certain our body is designed to withstand periods of a lack of nutrition and sustenance.
Right.
And in other words, what we would call fasting. I think it's natural. I think the body craves that break from the constant, if you think about it, why can't we get healthy? we're constantly taxing our body by forcing it to go into the process of digestion itself and never giving it a break so it could do some proper cleansing, detoxification, and healing.
We've been programmed into a constant state of craving.
Constant state of craving, so we're in a constant state of consuming, and therefore our body's in a constant state of processing what we've consumed, and it never really, we never imagine the decades and decades and decades of our life when we've never really given it a chance to catch up.
Absolutely.
Why can't we get healthy? We're not paying attention, we're not educated, we're not doing the research, we're not making the effort to determine what it would take to get healthy, taking responsibility for our own health, taking the reins of our own lives and our own body and nourishing them, simply nourishing our bodies to be able to thrive.
And like with so many things, the first place to make any forward progress is just to stop and assess where you're at.
Yeah, stop, thank you. Yeah. We want to change, we're going in for the brick wall, we want to change direction. Physics requires us to stop, reorient our bearing, and then head the other way. So this whole thing about stopping is so valuable, because how are we going to assess if we're still running? We're not going to be able to assess. We've got to stop and take inventory, look in that mirror, make some determinations, get some support from our tribe, go to the healthiest person you know and ask them how they do it, what their tricks are, what their secrets are. You know, follow the lead of people whom you respect, as they get it and they care and they're doing something about it and you're seeing the results. Emulate them.
So the real answer to why we can't get healthy is because we're not really trying very hard to be healthy.
Yeah, I think
and we've been programmed against it, all fairness. It's not really your fault.
And that's true, too. But also, we think we are trying. But our attempts are often in vain or they're futile. We follow the low-fat program or the sugar-free program, which just means chemical nightmare.
Yeah.
You know? So those words are dangerous. Look out for them. They don't have to put a sugar-free label on the kale.
No.
They don't have to put a fat-free label on the basket of strawberries. Nature's done the work for us, and we have a massive cornucopia.
Literally color-coded it for us.
Yes, literally. They color-coded it. Eat all the colors. Eat a red raspberry and a green kiwi and a yellow banana and an orange for your breakfast, and you're on the right track already. Eat a green salad and a red pomegranate and brown nuts.
So while we may be the most intelligent creatures in the known universe, according to us, we are definitely the universe's absolute worst pupils, because we don't learn anything.
Yeah, we're smart and we don't learn. It's kind of ironic. So
eat with love. That's it. Just eat with love.
Eat with love. Love yourself.
Yeah.
Love yourself enough to put the attention towards doing the research, making the choices, enlisting support from the tribe. That is an essential element that so many of us miss, because we are tribal creatures. We're ultra social, and without the support of the tribe, it's almost futile. Have you ever tried really hard to do something and everyone around you was doing the thing you're trying not to do? It is almost impossible. It's a hostile environment when they're all eating the chocolate cake and you're trying to do the diet, whatever that means. So let's come up with some new traditions. Let's eat apples for each other's birthday and carve a hole and put a candle in them. Let's make new traditions. Let's find a context in which we can share quality time and create ritual around a salad instead of a pizza, etc., etc., etc. These are just food for thought, pun intended, but just some ideas to get you started on your own path of health and thriving. We're on ours. We hope you're on yours. We'd love for you to join the conversation. We'd love to help support you in this. We'd love for the Soul Tribe to be a healthy, engaging, nourishing place for the soul and for the body. And we're here to support that.
Come to souldocumentary.love. We're going to love you. We're going to feed you right. We want some love back, and we've got a documentary coming out. Can you believe it? On Jock Fresco and the Venus Project, A World Worth Imagining. Jock Fresco, the man with the plan, it's coming to you on 11/11. So stay tuned. We're posting all sorts of trailers and stuff. It's so exciting.
Definitely super exciting. And we're going to be back here next Thursday for some more soul perspectives. We're always happy to share our perspectives with you, for you, and on behalf of our entire human family. We're doing our part to help accelerate the progress of our thriving, and we need you We need your help, your experience, your input, your expertise, your effort, your time, and your heart. Let's add more heart to everything we do, just like the Heart Math Institute suggests. And we're all in this together, and we're interdependent, and we're ultra social. So thanks for your support.
We love you.
Thanks for tuning in. Comment down below and join the conversation. We'll see you next week. In the meantime,
it's all a matter of
perception. 2, 3, 4.
It's all